但是刚开始两天呢，可能很多事情还需要继续适应。
But in the first 2 days, we must still adjust to certain things.
所以愿主耶稣啊，给我们有力量啊，去克服我们各方面的困难。
So we ask the Lord Jesus Christ to give us the strength to overcome these difficulties.
能够把心沉淀下来。
And so that we can establish our hearts.
Calm down, 好，那我们就可以更容易亲近神。
So we can calm down our hearts so that we can draw near to God.
小弟每次这个跟大家分享，大部分都是讲不完。
Usually when I share, I cannot complete it.
所以如果这次讲不完，你们就知道为什么了。
So if I cannot finish it, 哥
林多后书讲不完了。
Understand.
我们查哥林多后书啊，我们知道它有一个前书嘛，哈。
And Second Corinthians follows the First Corinthians.
你们有讲义哈，那讲义我有改写过，所以如果跟你的讲义不太一样哈，请你自己改哈。
I have made adjustments to your draft, to your outline. So if there are differences, please make the adjustment.
那哥林多教会是保罗第二次宣道旅行所建立的教会。
The Corinthian church was established during the second missionary trip of Paul.
那这里是一个宣道旅行第二次旅行的图。
And this in the next slide, we will see the map of the second missionary trip.
哥林多教会你如果看图它是在图的左边下面啊。
And if
next slide, please.
See the map. It is at the bottom portion of the map.
左边
Left bottom portion of the map.
那在现在它应该是希腊，在希腊的一个地方了哈。
And in the present time, it is in Greece.
那我们稍微了解一下它的地形哈。
And this is for us to have an understanding of the geography.
下一个 slide， 我们看它的时间表。
And now let us examine the timeline.
这个。保罗写哥林多教会大概在主后55年写成的。
Paul wrote Second Corinthians around 55 A.D.
他去拜访哥林多教会应该有三次。
And he visited the Church of Corinth 3 times.
我们来看哥林多后书12:14。
Let's refer to Second Corinthians chapter 12:14.
12:14。
Chapter 12:14.
12:14。
Chapter 12:14。
12:14。
Chapter 12:14。
如今我打算第三次到你们那里去，也不必累着你们，因为我所求的是你们，不是你们的财物。这边提到说保罗打算第三次去他那里。
Paul wanted to go visit Corinth for a third time.
所以应该有三次的拜访。
So there must have been 3 visitations.
那第一次他到那里，这个是逃，这个从帖撒罗尼迦逃，然后又从利比亚逃，那逃逃到这个哥林多那边去。
And the first time he had been escaping from Thessalonica, and he went to Corinth.
到了雅典，再到哥林多哈。
And after visiting Athens, he reached Corinth.
那这个在第一次的宣道旅程当中呢，他可能待了就是在这次旅程当中待了一年半。
And during the course of this trip, he stayed there for about a year and a half.
后来回来的时候，那边有很多的问题。
And after he returned from this visit, there were many difficulties and problems that arose.
我们提过了，就是有分派的问题。有的人说他属亚波罗，有的人说他属这个保罗，有的人说他们属彼得。
There were problems of divisions and factions when they claimed that they belonged to Apollo or Peter.
那后来呢？大概这三个人，可能是三个人带哥林多前书去哥林多教会哈。
And there were
看哥林多前书16:3。
Three people who brought this letter to the Church of Corinth.
我们看这是前书了哈，前书。
Let's refer to First Corinthians chapter 16.
16:1.
Chapter 16.
10.
Verse 10.
若是提摩太来到你们，要留心，叫他在你们那里无所惧怕，因为他劳力做主的工，像我一样。11。所以无论谁都不可以藐视他，只要送他平安前行。 叫他到我这里来，因我指望他和弟兄同来。十二节，至于兄弟亚波罗，我再三劝他同弟兄们到你们那里去，但这时他绝不愿意去了，即使有了机会他必去。好，我们跳过来读十六节
verse
16，读十五节，十五节。弟兄们，你们晓得斯提凡一家是亚该亚初结的果子，并且他们以服侍圣徒为念。十六节，我劝你们顺服这样的人，并一切同工同劳的人。十七节，斯提凡拿弗拿图并胡拿图都并亚该古到这里来，我很欢喜，因为你们待我有不及之处，他们补上了，他们叫我的心里都快活。这样的人你们要尊重。
18.
所以有三个人从哥林多教会到保罗那边去了。
And there were three people who went to Paul from the Church of Corinth.
就是十八、十六节、十六节所记载的，十七节所记载的这三个人。
Recorded in verse 17.
那他们应该是把这个信带回去哥林多教会这样子。
And they must have brought this letter back to the Corinthian church.
那我们看到这个问题保罗试着要派提摩太去解决。
And Paul had originally intended for Timothy to go and solve this problem.
提摩太也没有帮他解决完，没有帮他解决了。
But Timothy was unable to solve it.
提摩太书谈到提摩太有胃病啊。
And the book of Timothy talks about how he had a stomach problem.
我在猜，一定是到哥林多教会太紧张了紧张到胃病，没办法解决问题啊。
And I conjecture that he must have been very nervous from going to the Church of Corinth and being unable to solve these problems.
今天如果教会有问题有时候会吓死工人呢。
Sometimes when there are problems in the church, it might scare the workers to death.
所以你叫亚波罗去，亚波罗说：“这时候我绝对不会去的，你们教会太可怕了。”
Therefore, when he called Apollos to go, he was afraid to go.
可是保罗他一心想要去帮助他们呢。
And yet Paul resolved that he wanted to go and help them.
但是有时候去他们没有悔改见到面大家 keep 一边拍垮。大家这个见到面呢，大家你也不用悔改我有又话又要说，所以有时候延迟去了。
But when he went and they were unwilling to repent, it caused a very awkward situation.
所以后来这个困难当然是提多解决了，这在哥林多后书有交代。
And finally, this issue was resolved by Titus in 2 Corinthians.
所以我们看保罗去访问第二次的时候派提摩太去没有解决，他自己去第二次也是没有解决了。
Paul sent Timothy, and it was unresolved. When he went a second time, it was still unresolved.
我们来看哥林多后书十三章第二节。
Now let's refer to 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 2.
哥林多后书十三章第二节。
2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 2.
十三章第二节。
Chapter 13, verse 2.
我从前说过，如今不在你们那里，又说，正如我第二次见你们的时候所说的一样，就是对那犯了罪跟奇异的人说，我若再来，必不宽容你们。所以第二次去说问题没有解决了，我再来你们小心
And he's warning them that because he was unable to solve the problem on his second visit, they should be warned for the third time.
所以哥林多后书就是第三次去之前，提多已经帮他解决完了，他去之前所写的一部书。
Therefore, this letter of 2 Corinthians was written after Titus had resolved the issue before Paul was going to visit.
读到这个问题，然后我们来想一想，我们美国真耶稣教会有没有问题？
And when we consider this issue, we must ask ourselves if in the True Jesus Church in the U.S. we have these problems.
有人点头。
Some people have nodded.
这个，你们猜传道最怕什么问题
？What kind of problem is the one that the minister fears the most？
你们当中怕赶鬼的，请举手。
Who is afraid of casting out evil spirits？
通常传道除了我以外，大家都不怕赶鬼。
Except for me, nobody is afraid of casting out evil spirits.
我的意思就是说，赶鬼反正是神给权柄了，只要祷告，弟兄姐妹同心合意，应该都赶得掉。知道问题的在哪里，都可以赶得掉。
In other words, through prayer and the authority of Christ, then and the unity of the believers, they can be cast out.
那一般传道最怕教会有什么问题
？And what is the greatest fear of a minister?
你们猜猜看。
Let us guess.
人事问题。
human relations.
真的，有时候还没有去就开始头痛了。
Sometimes before they even arrive, they already have to be troubled by it.
这个有时候连保罗这么有恩赐啊，跟你说教会他也搞不定啊。
Even though Paul was very gifted and talented, he couldn't resolve the problems in Corinth.
啊，当然，教会的问题除了人事问题之外呢，还有真理的问题，对真理认知的问题。
Aside from the problems of human interaction, there is also a problem of the understanding of the truth.
所以你看，哥林多教会人事问题就是大家分党派嘛，为了谁属谁分党派啊。那真理的问题就是他们对于这个除名的问题哦，那个为什么要除名呢？不用除名了，没有除名制度了。所以哦，他们那个娶继母的还以这个，你看我们都原谅他，以这个做夸口，以这个做荣耀啊。保罗说：“你这种人要赶出去。”啊，哥林多前书第五章了哦。
One of the problems that they had is that of human relations, where they divided into factions, and as to the truth, they were divided on the issue of excommunication. They even boasted about the sin.
这是真理认知的问题。
And this is a problem of the understanding of the truth.
第三个问题，我们看这现在的，现在应该比较没有，他们，现在其实也有，就是对保罗不认同的问题啊。
And the third problem is a lack of recognition of Paul.
你是使徒吗？
Are you an apostle?
你又不是原来那十二个人呢、啊、
？You're not one of the original 12 disciples.
如果你是使徒的话，为什么讲话又粗俗，土里土气的这样子啊，土土的
？If you're an apostle, how come you're not eloquent in your speech?
今天我们教会也有这样的问题啊，不是完全的，对人没有问题，但对总会有问题。
Even in our church today, we see these problems. They might not have problems against an individual, but against the USGA.
有些教会不晓得为什么一谈到总会就要跳起来。有些不是教会了，应该说部分弟兄姐妹一谈到总会就说啊，那个不知道民间疾苦的地方，或者是说啊，这个都是专横的地方，就是一谈到总会他就会跳起来啊。
And some members are very critical of the USGA.
这是我自己在看的，不晓得你怎么看。我们现在的真耶稣教会在美国也有这些类似这样的问题。
And this is only in my own opinion. We have the same problems in our church in the U.S. today.
但是没有关系，我们都是得救的教会。
But even so, we are still the church of salvation.
所以保罗叫哥林多教会叫圣徒啊。
And that is why he calls them
saints.
Saints.
我们都是圣徒呢。
We are all saints.
我们的圣徒观念跟这个天主教的圣徒观念不太一样。
Our understanding of sainthood is different from that of the Catholic Church.
我们来看哥林多前书第一章。
Let's refer to 1 Corinthians chapter 1.
第一章的第二节。
1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 2.
写信给哥林多神的教会，就是基督耶稣里成圣蒙召做圣徒的。连哥林多这么糟糕的教会，他们也是圣徒呢。
Even such a troublesome church as Corinth was also labeled a church of saints.
所以圣徒的定义就是蒙主耶稣宝血洗净成圣啊，有成圣的身份啊，这样就是圣徒啊。
Therefore, a saint is a person who has been received the remission of sins through the blood of Jesus Christ.
所以我们不要小看自己哦。
That is why we should not underestimate ourselves.
我们旁边这位是 Saint Liliana.
And so this is Saint Liliana.
Yeah. 那我们再看下一章哈。
Let's refer to the next slide.
那继续看时间表。哥林多，你读哥林多后书的时候，要有一个 timeline 的观念，有一个时间的观念。
We must consider a timeline as we are reading the book of Second Corinthians.
我们看哥林多后书的二章十三节。
Second Corinthians chapter 2 verse 13.
二章十三节。
Chapter 2 verse 13.
十二节到十三节。
Verse 12 and 13.
哥林多后书二章十二节到十三节。
Second Corinthians chapter 2, verse 12 through 13.
我从前为基督的福音到了托罗亚，主也给我开了门。十三节。
13.
那时因为没有遇见兄弟提多，我心里不安，便辞别那里的人往马其顿去了。这么提到这个保罗派提多去解决哥林多教会问题的时候呢，本来想要本来想说提多会回来回报，但是找不到提多了。
After Paul had sent Titus to resolve this problem in Corinth, he had waited for his report, but Titus was nowhere to be found.
他后来去特罗亚等提多啊。
He even went to the city of Troas to wait for Titus.
请问这张图特罗亚在哪里？
Where is Troas?
特罗亚有没有看到特罗亚在哪里？在那个，你们有没有讲义？有讲义哈，对，在那个最右边那一块的那个角落那里哈。
It's on a right corner.
你们有地图吗？有找到了，请举手。特罗亚。
We have found it. Please raise your hand.
就是最右边那一块图的那一块图的上最上面一个黑色的字。
It is on the right hand side of the landmass on the right.
那哥林多是在过海嘛，对不对哈？马其顿也是过海嘛，马其顿在哥林多的上面呢。
Corinth and Macedonia are across the sea.
所以他实在是，其实传到特罗亚哦，神给他的福音哦开了门呢。
And when he preached to Troas, the gate of the gospel was open.
但是他心还是挂念着哥林多教会啊。
But even in his heart, he still was concerned with the Corinthian church.
哎呀，不晓得提多有没有处理这个问题哦，到底有没有处理好？
He didn't know if Titus had resolved these issues.
后来呢，特地过海去看了。
And
he
across the sea to find out.
到哪里去？到这个马其顿的，马其顿更多的上面这个这块地方叫马其顿的。
He went to Macedonia, which is above Corinth.
你看那块中间那一块白色那个字就是 Macedonia 的哈。
It is the central piece with the white lettering.
哎，为什么他不到哥林多教会去
？And why didn't he go straight to Corinth？
哦，这个你可以体会到他的心哈，他是又急又想知道，但是呢。这个反正我去已经大概 keep 一边了，所以我还是不要去啊！哎呦呦，这么等啊！因为我去就要你们不悔改，我去就要做处理啦。所以呢，他就是急很急，赶快过海，可是又有一句话不知道怎么讲哈、哦。哎，所以他还是在马其顿的，没有下到哥林多啊。
And the reason why he didn't go straight to Corinth and stay in Macedonia is because he had conflicted emotions where he, on the one hand, had the urge to go and see them, but on the other hand, he did not want to come and rebuke them while they were unrepentant.
那我们要跳到第七章的第五节来。
Let's refer to chapter 7, verse 5.
你这个一定要连着读，我们要连着读才知道整个这个时间呢、啊。
We must study this together to understand the chronology.
七章第五节。
Chapter 7, verse 5.
我们从前就是到了马其顿的时候，身体也不安宁，周围患难，外有征战，内有惧怕。第六节。
Verse 6.
但那安慰丧气之人的神，借着提多来安慰了我们。第七节。
Verse 7.
不但借着他来，也借着他从你们所得的安慰，安慰了我们，因他把你们的想念、哀痛。像我的热心都告诉了我，叫我更加欢喜。哦，感谢主啊！终于啊，这个提多啊，从哥林多啊往北边走啊，啊，走到这个马其顿那边啊，去跟保罗会面呢、啊。
Thank God, Titus went north from Corinth and met with Paul in Macedonia.
本来他在特罗亚福音很兴旺，跑到这边来，圣经上特别讲他这个内有征战啊，内有惧怕，外有征战。
Initially in Troas, he was very successful in preaching, but when he came to Macedonia, he faced conflicts on the outside and fears within.
也应该在那边生病了啦。
And
身体不得安宁了。
Even fell ill.
我想他内心的征战一定是为哥林多教会在那边焦急。
And he must have been very troubled for the Corinthian church.
哦，感谢主，安慰丧气之人的提多终于来了。
But thank God, comfort came at the hands of Titus.
哦，他说呢，你们有哀痛啦，你们有这个有想念啦，吼啊，你们有热心啦，你们有悔改啦，啊，你们那个变好的事情呢，终于让我们都知道了。
And Titus reported about their longing and their deep sorrow and their repentance.
啊，所以感谢主，是提多解决了这个哥林多教会的问题。
And thank God, Titus resolved the problems of the Church of Corinth.
所以、哦、这本书、哦、
Next slide.
这本书主要就在谈那个很多 保罗那个心情的一种描述了。
And this book describes many of the emotions and personal life of Paul.
里面谈到你在很多其他书信找不到的他那种患难啦、啊，那种辛苦啦、啊，他那种心境啊。
And in this book, you find this toil and this agony that is not found in other books.
那你也看到保罗为自己辩白。
We also see that he even goes to the point of defending himself.
甚至自夸。
Even boasting.
我们会读这个问题，为什么自夸是好吗？那有时候真的是不得已啊。他为了要对付那个所谓的 super apostle， 那些大的使徒啊，那个。我们谈什么叫伟大，那么大最大的使徒，其实那些他必须要自夸，被强迫要自夸。
And we will study why the reason for this self-boasting and his comparison to the super apostles.
所以这封信是很个人表白的一封信呢。
Therefore, this is a very personal letter.
所以到最后保罗终于得到了安慰哈。
Finally, Paul was comforted.
我们来读这个哥林多后书第七章。第七章。
Chapter 7.
十七啊，十五节，十六节。
Verse 15 and 16.
第七章十五节是十六节。
Second Corinthians chapter 7, verse 15 and 16.
并且提多想起你们众人的顺服是怎么样恐惧战惊的接待他，他爱你们的心肠就越发热了。十六节。
16.
我如今欢喜，能在凡事上为你们放心。哇，我想解决之后，即使外面有征战，里面就没有恐惧了啦。
And after these problems are resolved, even though there are conflicts on the outside, he did not have any more fear or panic with them.
他欢喜了。
He was joyful.
他凡事为哥林多教会的人来放心呐。
And he was in complete confidence about the Corinthian church.
这个就是这部书的大概的介绍。
And this is an introduction to the book of 2 Corinthians.
因为哥林多后书啊，谈了很多保罗个人的心情啊，尤其是他所遇到的苦难呐。
And this book speaks about Paul's emotions and the difficulties that he encountered.
你们下午有做功课的时间吗？
You have homework time in the afternoon.
功课做得完做不完？
Do you have enough time to complete your assignments?
做一下了，拜托。哥林多后书哈，你去找一下保罗的苦难，好不好？
For 2 Corinthians, find the trials and tribulations of Paul.
就是他谈到自己的心情了哈。
And he talks of his own emotions.
教会是神的家。
The church is the house of God.
一个教会如果有问题哈，只要我们继续浇灌，继续培养，神一定会给他们带出来。
And if a church faces problems, when we continue to develop and care for it, God will resolve it.
那有时候在处理问题，有时候如果有癌症还是要割啊，要不然整体就完蛋了。
Sometimes when there are problems, even to the point of cancer, sometimes you must amputate it, or it will damage the whole.
这是我第一个感想，读哥林多前后书，觉得说教有问题，有时候是没有办法避免的，但是。如果有人像保罗一样用书信啊派人啊自己本身没有办法处理派其他的人有恩赐不同的到最后神会把那个教会带出来。
And this is my first reflection about the book of 2 Corinthians that even as they are facing problems and then Paul sent different people to care for it, in the end, God resolved it.
因为教会是神的家。
Because the church is the house of God.
神自己会做主。
And God is the master.
那借着祷告，大家最后一定能够达到同心合意的程度。
And through prayer, we are united in mind and spirit.
那第二个感想有关这本书，我就觉得个人恩赐真的不一样。
My second reflection is that every person has different abilities.
其实提摩太做很多的功啊，你看保罗多少书信都是讲这封信是他跟提摩太一起来写的，或者是提摩太是保罗的，可以说是一个很得意的跟他一起做很多圣工的人呢。
And Timothy, we know he engaged in many different types of labors, and he's often mentioned by Paul as being a collaborator in his works.
但是提摩太也没有办法解决这个教会的问题。
But Timothy was unable to resolve the issues in this church.
最后提多把他解决了，所以工人有不同的恩赐。
It was finally resolved by Titus, so different workers have different gifts.
所以有时候神派不同的人来我们弟兄姐妹要懂得。善用工人的恩赐。
Therefore, when God sends us different workers, we must make good use of the different abilities.
人家有人说，所谓天才就是把一个人放在对的地方了。 有人这样讲了、
哦、Some people say that genius is to place a person in the right location.
比如说你到非洲去，你到丛林去、啊。
For example, if you go to Africa,
很多地方没有水，没有食物，在丛林里面，你那个土人他就有办法找到水，找到食物，然后你就有办法生存下来。
Even though there is no water, the natives are able to find the water and help you survive.
那你会把它当成这个土，黑水土人当成一个哇，真是丛林天才啊
！And you will think that this person who found the water is like a genius.
In the forest.
Oh, in the forest.
但你把它放到美国的办公室来，它变成办公室白痴啊！
But if you bring this African native into an office in the U.S., he will not function as well.
因为你叫他摸电脑，他可能不会，因为他是生活在丛林里面的人呢、啊。
He might not know how to manage a computer because he has survived in the forest.
所以哦，我们每个人都有一个神可以给我们用的地方，我们只要知道自己的恩赐在哪里，用那个恩赐服事。
Therefore, every person has abilities given by God. Therefore, we must use them in accordance to these gifts.
所以教会里面就是好像一个身体，我们有不同的 function 要彼此搭配。
The church is a body with different functions, and we must collaborate with one another.
这有些科学家是音乐白痴哎。
Some scientists are musically challenged.
啊，我读了一篇文章，听说毕卡索要去学写诗啊，写那个诗 poem， 要做诗人呢。
I heard that Picasso wanted to become a poet.
那怎么写都是写不好啊。
And he was not adept at writing poems.
所以了解自己应该神给我们什么，这个很重要哦。
It is essential that we understand what gifts God has given us.
在哪里服事
？And where we should serve.
那最后这本书啊，有，我们来看最后的几句话。
Let's refer to the last few comments on this book.
哥林多后书的十三章十一节。
Second Corinthians chapter 13 verse 11.
啊，哥林多后书十三章十一节。
Second Corinthians chapter 13 verse 11.
哎，下一页哈 ，next slides。十三章十一节。
Chapter 13 verse 11.
还有末了的话，愿弟兄们都喜乐。啊，这边提到愿弟兄都喜乐，因为哈。这个保罗前面的书 给哥林多教会有很多的忧愁了。
And his wish was for them to be joyful because in his previous letters it had caused them sorrow.
那保罗本来有点后悔啊，写了这样的书让他们忧愁。后来化解到这个忧愁是暂时的忧愁，以后他们还是可以喜乐的。
And he was somewhat sorrowful that he had caused them grief, but he knew that in the end they would be joyful.
所以这部哥林多后书前面一部分就是在谈到这个忧愁与安慰的问题了、哦、
The first part of 2 Corinthians is talking about the contrast of grief and comfort.
那要做完全人。
And to become the perfect man.
因为哥林多教会有很多问题。
Because there are many problems in the Corinthian church.
要接受安慰。
And they must receive comfort.
因为他们有很多的哀伤。
Because they have many wounds.
要同心合意。
And they must be united in one
heart. 因为他们有很多的分歧。
Because there are many divisions.
要彼此和睦。
They must live in peace.
因为他们很多的不同的意见、啊、
Because they had different opinions.
所以这样如此仁爱和平的神必常与你们同在。所以我的意思就是说，我们读这一节就是让你看到后边呢，你也比较了解更多教会这一部书呢，主要在谈什么、啊、
And when we read this,
或是说哥林多教会有什么问题
？Concluding comment, then we know what this Second Corinthian letter is about and what issues they had.
我们看下个 slides。
Next slide。
我们来再谈一谈它整个书的结构。
Now we will review the structure of this letter。
如果我们读一部书啊，能够把它结构找出来，以后就是比较容易了解。
If we can understand the structure of a writing, then we can understand it better。
那它第一章啊，到第二章啊，就是在谈到形成改变的原因。
From chapter 1 to 2, it is speaking of the reasons for the change in their schedule。
因为他本来要去，后来决定不去了。
He had determined to go, and then he didn't go.
那这个就给哥林多教会有些人一些口实啊，有些人一些 excuse 啊，说你看保罗就是这样的人啊，变来变去的人啊。
And this gave some of the Corinthian believers an excuse to say that Paul was a person who changed his mind very easily.
所以他所传的福音也是变来变去的啦。
Therefore, his gospel is also changing all the time.
你要记得，哥林多教会有 super apostle。有那一种所谓的最大的使徒在里面。
In the Corinthian church, we had the super apostles.
所以他们对保罗本身就是反对的啦。
And therefore, they were in conflict with Paul.
所以你看，刚好就拿到一个把柄。你看， 说要来又不来，你看这个人变来变去，所以他所传的耶稣一定也是变来变去的耶稣了。
And then they found the shortcoming that they could criticize him about the gospel that he preached.
所以他在第一章就谈到他为什么要改变行程。
Therefore, in the first chapter, he speaks of why he changed his schedule.
这是从一章的十节到二章的十三节。
From verse 10 in chapter 1 to verse, chapter 2, verse 13.
那最后就是七章的五节。
And also chapter 7, verse 5.
这个都在谈这个问题。
They all discuss this matter.
我们刚刚已经读过了。
And we've already reviewed it.
他这个改变行程，后来他交代的原因跟结果是什么了？
Why he changed his schedule.
那这个中间呢，都在谈他的 missionary, humble missionary, 一些他所做的工作了。
And in the middle, he is discussing his ministry.
那哥林多后书，如果你用 ministry 这个字把它串起来也是蛮好的。
And we can also connect the whole of 2 Corinthians with this word of ministry.
要不要再做个功课？
How about another homework?
不是明天教了，先告诉你们功课是什么，好不好？这样可以吗？不要明天教。
It's not due tomorrow.
课程结束之后，课程结束之后，不是之后，最后一天才教嘛，好不好？
And it's due on the last day.
除非你们有其他功课。因为这个跟我谈的这个 ministry 这个字有关系啊。
It has to do with this word ministry.
如果你把这个字找出来，其实整个哥林多后书大概就可以了解了。
If we find the mentions of the word ministry, then we can understand the book of 2 Corinthians.
你们有没有电脑？有带电脑来的，请举手。
Who has brought their computer?
电脑有那个 computer software, 所以你们可以用 group study 。
And you can do this for your group study.
来，不用上网，因为用那个声音软体就可以了。
With a Bible software.
你找一个那个 Young's Notes 号码是1248。如果你懂英文，就找一个字叫做 Diaconia 啊。那个很多英文就是翻成 ministry。那这个字呢？我现在给你们，
帮
我念给你们了哈。你们找做很快。
Strong's number 1248。
哥林多后书3:7-9。
Second Corinthians.
后书三章七八九节哈。
Chapter 3, verse 8 and 9. 7, 8 and 9.
三章七节八节九节。这里有一个执事，对不对？
There's a deacon here.
这个执事呢，这应该是动词哈。这个执事就是 diaconia, 有些翻译翻成 ministry.
The word deacon.
Ministry, 就是宣道，就是所做的事情，就是执事。
The deacon, the original word is a verb that has to do with the ministry, which is to evangelize.
这是英文圣经翻成 ministry, 对不对？你的英文圣经翻 ministry, 请举手。
If this
很多人举手啊。
Called ministry in your book.
但是中文叫执事啊。
But in the Chinese version, it is called a deacon.
那同样的字呢，也翻成职分。
And the same word is referring to
stewardship.
Stewardship.
如果你有空，你查这个字哈，四章的一节，五章的十五节，六章的三节。
It's in chapter 4, verse 1 and chapter 5, verse 3.
四章一节谈到职分，对不对？
Chapter 4, verse 1 talks about stewardship.
对不起，我现在谈一些比较没有营养的，不知道也没有关系的东西了。但是知道了，你对哥林多后书会比较了解了。那个这个职事呢，这个职分呢，那个原文也叫 diaconia。他换 有的英文换成 ministry 的请举手 ministry
who has the word ministry
换成 stewardship 的请举手
stewardship
OK 中文换成职分其实跟职事这个也是同一个字
so this is the same stewardship is the same word as a deacon
五章的十五节跟六章的三节都是同样这个字
in chapter 5 verse 15 and 6 verse 3 is the same word
五章十五节
chapter 5 verse 15
是吗？不是，是五章的十八节了。
Chapter 5, verse 18.
这是职分。
This is a stewardship.
Stewardship, ministry. 六章的三节。
And chapter 6, verse 3.
六章的三节。
Chapter 6, verse 3.
免得职分被人毁谤，职分，对不对？
Again, stewardship.
这个原文也是 ministry, 对不对? Is it ministry?
In the original text, it is ministry.
Diakonia. 哦，那再来另外一个字的翻译哈。
And another translation.
我们看，八章的四节。
Chapter 8, verse 4.
八章四节。
Chapter 8, verse 4.
再三的求我们准他们在这供给圣徒的恩情上有份。供给这个事情，英文是不是也是 ministry？ 八章的第四节。
In chapter 8, verse 4, is there a mention of the word ministry？
是不是 ？Ministry， 请举手。OK， 所以这个供给也是个 ministry。你那个带钱去耶路撒冷帮助他们，这也是个 ministry。
To offer, take money of as offering to Jerusalem is also a ministry.
那你再看，你还有很多经文哦，你自己找哦。那再看最后一个十一章第八节，这是另外一个不同的翻译。
And let us also refer to chapter 11, verse 8. This is a different translation.
十一章第八节。
Chapter 11, verse 8.
我亏负了别的教会，向他们取了工价来给你们效力。这个效力也是 ministry.
And this word service is also ministry.
那我帮你们做了功课啦，你们把其他的没有找到的找出来就可以了。
You can find the rest of the mentions of this word ministry.
那为什么要讲这个呢？就是你用 ministry 这个字来看整本哥林多后书。
And you can use this word ministry to review the whole book of 2 Corinthians.
所以结构你把它分成三部分哈、哦。我现在请看结构。
And it can be divided. 为了
讲结构，所以讲那个字。所以结构你要记得第二章到第一章到第七章呢，他就谈到他的行程啦，为什么改变，然后最后他自己到马其顿，然后提多报好消息，从第二章开头，第七章结束，对不对
？And chapter 1 through chapter 7, it talks about his journey of who he sent and how it was resolved in chapter 7 by Titus.
Why he changed the schedule, then finally he go to Macedonia himself, and then he solved the problem, all the journey, right? 他就记这些东西，那这个。这个前后那中间差一大堆什么东西就差进保罗 ministry 的一些工作的 information 啊，就是有关他的宣道旅程当中所做的一些事情啊。
And in the middle he has injected a description of his ministry.
那八九章就谈到奉献对圣徒的供给 offering， 那这个就是一个 ministry。 我们刚刚不是说对圣徒的供给，供给那个字也叫 ministry 吗？所以八九章啊，八九章就是ministry to Jerusalem，对耶路撒冷这种 ministry 是这种，其实八九章，如果你不想知道这个字，你就记得奉献就对了啦，谈供给的事情了，谈奉献的事情了。
And in chapter 8 and 9, it is discussing a ministry of offering to the saints in Jerusalem.
那第十章到十三章就在 defend 哦，就在谈到说我是有权柄的，我不得不自夸的。那我们刚刚不是读对哥林多效力吗？This is a ministry to Corinthian church. 这是对哥林多教会的 ministry， 是对他们的效力的一些权柄，跟他的一些什么呢？他不得不夸口的地方。
And in chapter 10 to 13, Paul is speaking about the authority that he has to minister to the church in Corinth, and about how he has to boast about himself.
就是对哥林多效力当中必要的权柄，还有他必要做的自夸了。
And it's about the ministry and the authority that he has and the boasting that he must indulge in.
那如果记住这个字，那哥林多就比较容易记哈。你看你，请你 screen down the slides 哈，到一个一二三四五六，第六啊，往下按六次。
Skip down six slides. It's a slide title of Paul's ministry.
你看这个就是我把整个哥林多，我们在这次要学习的整个主题啦，整个对哥林多的教会，哥林多后书要学习的几个有关 ministry 的主题，你可以用这个字贯穿整部书啦，英文都叫 ministry， 但是中文翻译的字不一样，但是如果你看你的那个讲义，它不能换成宣道啊，其实因为我没有改，其实它英文都是 ministry， 中文不是宣道，但是它突然想你要改过来，有的时候要换职事，有的时候要换职分，不太一样的。
And these are all the main things regarding ministry. Sometimes it is defined as stewardship in the Chinese.
Yes. Oh, 这个要看英文啊，我们看英文。对对，我知道。这个我们请谢长老再跟你回答。
In Chinese, there are two different.
我没有注意到，对不起。
Wording for this word ministry.
不过很好的问题哦，你下次我可以研究了。好，那我们来谈第八章几个小弟想要在这边分享的主题。
And in chapter 8, there are some themes.
除了这个时间点，二章从一章令到七章，二章令到七章，一章二章令到七章那个这个 journey 啊，改变形成的原因呢之外呢，就是用几个 ministry 这个 word 来贯穿整部书。
And aside from the journey recorded in chapter 1, 2, and 7, there is also this mention of the word ministry.
那第一个就是第一章一到三节到十一节有关宣道上面的 ministry 的一些辛苦跟安慰啊，我们。因为哥林多有很多的痛苦嘛，保罗有很多的痛苦，谈到痛苦跟安慰的问题。
And in chapter 1, verse 3 to 11, is speaking of the sufferings that the Corinthian church and Paul himself faced.
那第二章的十四节到十节谈到他那个，我们在职分上，主耶稣常常率领我们夸胜，在这种 ministry 上面呢，主耶稣常常率领我们夸胜，在宣道上面，主耶稣常常率领我们夸胜。
And in chapter 2, verse 14 to 17, the Lord Jesus himself gives us the victory in our ministry.
那第三开始谈到，你们就是我们的见信。我们在工作上面呢，在 ministry 上面呢，你们就是我们的一个见信。
And in chapter 3, verse 1 through 6, Paul calls the Corinthian church a letter of recommendation of his ministry.
再来就谈到，只是新约的执事比旧约的执事更荣耀。其实这份工作，这个 ministry 是很荣耀的。
And then it speaks of a greater glory in the New Testament as opposed to the Old Testament.
那因为做这个 ministry, 我们有个职分啊，中文翻职分，其实因为是个 ministry 啊，我们有个职分啊，这个职分本身是有能力的。
And this ministry brings with it ability.
那我们做这个工作我们最后我们有永恒的结果，所以第五章谈到我们向往天上的那个房子穿上天上的房子。
An eternal result.
那再来在这个宣道上有一个恳求，今天早上我们勉励了我求你们，我拜托你们，你们真的是要跟基督和好，要替主活。
And there is a beseeching and begging them for them to be reunited with Christ and to live with
Christ. 那第八章第九章就是对耶路撒冷的 ministry, 就是供给的问题，捐献的问题。
And verse 19 is speaking of the offering and the ministry towards the Corinthians.
十章到十三章就是谈到他的夸口跟权柄的问题。
10 to 13 is a discussion of authority and self-boasting.
如果你这样看这样去想，可能整个更多后书比较容易记。
And it will be easier to understand and remember 2 Corinthians if you follow the structure.
这是我所学习的分享。
And this is what I have learned.
好了，那就是这样了。哥林多前书就交后书就结束了。
And this is the end of 2 Corinthians.
这是 forest 你看到一个森林，它的结构就是这样子。
And this is the forest view.
明天开始我们来看一棵一棵的树木
After tomorrow, we will look at each tree.
除了刚刚那个张姐妹的问题，还有没有其他的问题？
Are there any other questions?
如果你有问题，我们都可以请谢长老回答。
We can ask Elder Shea to respond to them.
Yes. 我们那个讲义里面，我们会如果主要是给我时间，那个最大的使徒就是假使徒了。
The question is about the super.
十二使徒没有一个比较大的了。我们今天说要传道也没有一个比较大的，我们只有比较老的。
They are actually false apostles in the church.
所以你仔细去读 ，I'm sorry.
There are no super apostles. That everyone is equal.
所以你看读哥林多后书，最大的使徒是 sarcastic, 是一种反讽的讲法。
And the term super apostles in the book of Second Corinthians is a sarcastic label.
他是在，他们是假使徒。
They are actually false apostles.
好，我们以后再分析。好，谢谢你的问题。
Thank you for your question.
有空请你读《哥林多后书》。
If you have time, please study the book of Second
Corinthians. 先读完《哥林多后书》，再做其他两个问题。
And after you read the whole book, then you can do the two.
那你们读的时候，把这个 ministry 这个字放在心里面，好不好
？And as you study it, remember this term ministry.
好，我们一起来祷告，是不是？十二点二十结束，对不对？我们一起来祷告。
Let's pray together.